Are you guys? Right now, I am here with Lauren Lolo Spencer, model, actress, and disability lifestyle influencer.
Yes.
Tell us what that is.
So a disability lifestyle influencer is essentially like any other influencer online, someone who focuses on how to better your lifestyle by collaborating with brands and collaborating with other people to ultimately push a positive lifestyle and energy out to the world. I just specifically like to focus on people with disabilities and what is unique to our lifestyle, and collaborating with brands and other people that speak to the audience specifically, and kind of just make life with a disability a lot more easy than what it naturally is.
Now, I just read your CNN article that came out today, okay, doing big things, and you talk about influencer porn and how you try to stay away from that. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Well, it's what it's called is inspiration porn. So inspiration porn is a societal term that people within the disability community kind of use as a way to kind of talk about, you know, able-bodied people in the community, because a lot of the times we feel like people use us as a reason to be inspired over things that are not necessarily deemed to be inspirational. You know, I always use the example of people coming up to me, "Oh, you're so brave to eat in public by yourself." And I'm like, is that really brave? And why is it brave? Because it's me. You know, like, did you go up to that lady's over there by herself? Like, are you saying the same thing? So that's kind of like an example of where people are just always so inspired by what we're doing when we're literally just existing in the world like everyone else. So that's kind of what we mean by inspiration porn. Like, people just getting off to us being here in the world and existing like anybody else.
Right. I have a cousin who's he was paralyzed 9 years ago.
Oh, okay.
From the neck down.
Yeah.
And he says that all the time. He's like, why are they looking at me because I'm wheeling into an elevator?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Like, yeah, it's literally that feeling. It's like those moments where it's like, you know, they just want to be so inspired and feel like we're doing such great things. And it's like, no, I just got to get upstairs.
So what is your story? You were diagnosed with ALS.
Yes.
At the age of 14.
Yes. Yes.
How did you find that out? Like, how did it come to that diagnosis?
Well, it definitely was a very long journey. But ultimately, I just had an experience with my body where I noticed my right arm was significantly weaker than it normally was. And so just through time and doctors and all of that kind of stuff, eventually it led to a diagnosis of ALS. I have recently kind of gone through my own personal, trying to see if I just maybe have been misdiagnosed or something along the lines of that. So I like to just kind of say at this point that I'm undiagnosed, but a lot of times, you know, it's just easier to say I was diagnosed with ALS because people are going to like, no, I want to know the answer. And it's just like, okay, fine. I'll just tell you something.
Right, right.
In that way, yeah.
So what is your philosophy on life? You know, I have all of our able-bodied friends and family. Yes. They complain about the most trivial things.
Yes.
To you, what motivates you to get out of bed? And what would you tell someone that's complaining about, you know, say, a bad day, you know, mm-hmm. or a breakup or whatever?
Yeah. That's a loaded answer to a great question. You know, my motivation getting out of bed is knowing that I got the opportunity to wake up that morning. That alone is good enough for me. I feel like, you know, not everyone gets to wake up. Not everyone gets to experience the rest of their day. And for me to be able to have that opportunity and set my intention in the morning to just go out, be of service, be as positive as I can be, and living within that space as best as I can be, because I obviously have my days just like everyone else does, is the thing that really just motivates me.
I love that. And you're killing the game. You got a movie coming out, right?
Yes, I do.
Tell us about the movie real quick.
Yay. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm really excited about the movie. So I am in a film called Give Me Liberty. It is literally the most interesting, day in the life of this medical transport driver. And I play Tracy, who is one of the passengers on the van. And we'll just say she doesn't make it easy for the driver that day.
Okay, I could see that. I could see, got a lot of energy.
Yes, she has a lot of energy, a lot of things to say. But it's honestly a really, really amazing, heartfelt story about human connections, multiple worlds that are completely opposite from each other, all coming together in this one place, which is this van, and everyone kind of navigating their energies and their emotions within that day. So it's really, I'm not saying that because I'm in it. That's what I meant to say. I'm not saying that it's really, really good because I'm in it. But I mean, we did premiere at Sundance and we premiered at Cannes Film Festival. So.
Okay. All right. I love it.
Good.
Do they have a release date yet?
So we have a theatrical release here in the U.S. Sometime this summer. And that's all I can say.
That is so exciting. All right.
I'm so excited.
Please tell everybody where they can find you online.
Yes, so you can find me on Instagram at It's Lolo Love, ItsLoloLove. And you can find me on my YouTube channel, Sitting Pretty, youtube.com/sittingprettylolo, all one word. And yeah, just come check me out, see what I've got going on. I'm always modeling, I'm acting, I'm public speaking, I'm all over the place. So yeah, just follow me and see my journey.
I had so much fun talking to you. Yeah. You guys are watching Healthcare TV Network.